on meditation, various workshops. So today we are here for another one, which is on the third eye. Okay, which is on the third eye, and we will try to meditate in different ways on the third eye, and we'll talk about what is third eye and what is the benefits of meditating on the third eye. So first, let's chant Om so that we create some positive vibrations, and then we can carry on with our talk. So keep your spine straight, relax your shoulders and forehead, inhale. Om. Inhale. Open your eyes and stretch. All right, relax. Fine. So, yeah, you can come forward, sit here. Come forward. So, first of all, I would like to ask you if you have heard about the third eye. You are aware of third eye? Everybody, you are aware? So what is third eye? He says pineal gland. You say here. Okay. Here. Okay, so this is, now this lady is putting a big bindi. So this is the third eye. This is the place for third eye, and that is the reason that why in the ancient times all these tilak and bindis were prescribed, and now it has become a fashion, so we use colors and lot of things. Earlier it was with some certain chemicals, so that those chemicals, when you apply here, like you used to do with haldi, kumkum, chandan, bhasmi, these are the things which carry energy, and when you apply them here, then they will stimulate your third eye. So objective was to stimulate your third eye with the help of these things. And third eye, as many of you know, is situated here behind the forehead, between the eyebrows, and it is inside. So say 2 to 2.5 inches inside is the place of the third eye. And why it is called as third eye? Any idea? See, because with the two eyes you will see the physical world, and that is a direct through eyes you see, and then this third eye, which is between two eyes, if this opens up, this activates, then you don't need to see with the two eye, and what cannot be seen with the two eyes, that can be seen with the third eye. Without the help of two eyes, your third eye can see beyond, and this is generally popularly also called as intuition, or also called as vision, intuition. So this, antar chakshu, so he's saying antar chakshu, divya jyoti, divya drishti. Divya Drishti, like how in Bhagavad Gita you read that Arjun was conferred Divya Drishti. Because with the normal physical eyes, there are so many things which you cannot see. Vision power. So that is seen through third eye. And in the colloquial language, you also call it Tisri Aankh. Why? Because it is between the two eyes. But this third eye cannot be seen. It can see, but it cannot be seen. That is the beauty. The third eye is there in everyone, every human being. It is not meant that only for some human being it is there. This third eye is there for each and every human being, irrespective of the country and the religion and the race, it is there for everyone. But it is in the dormant state. Dormant, you understand? Dormant means it is sleeping, it is unactivated. So it is dormant, and you can activate the third eye through various means. You can activate your third eye. And then once your third eye activates, then you can have visions, you can have better sharp intuition, you can have more wisdom. Wisdom is something which comes from third eye. When you can understand the things, when you see the things, you can understand the reality. Because two eyes see so many things and then they confuse the mind. That what is the true essence, what is the truth behind the whole thing. But this third eye is not confused. This third eye is never confused. That is the importance of third eye. It is not confused. It is always clear in the essence. It will know what is the truth. When the two eyes see so many things, then you don't know what is true, what is false, what is the essence, what is the reality. But when this third eye opens, you always know what is the reality, what is the truth. So this sees the truth. Third eye sees the truth. So in Bible, it is said that when your two eyes become one, and then when you see with that one eye, then whole body will be filled with light. Because then you will see everything in true sense. Then the truth will be revealed to you. If you see from third eye, if you see from two eyes, you will be confused. From third eye, you know the truth. Okay? If you see a person, then two eyes might get confused, you know, what kind of clothes he is wearing, what kind of, you know, attitude he is having, what kind of way he is speaking, ways he is walking. So you will try to analyze through all these things and you might get deceived. That may not reveal the truth. He might be wearing good clothes, he might be smart, talking smartly, whatever. But what gives the truth is third eye. If your third eye sees, then there is no deceiving. Then the third eye knows exactly what it is. There is no deceiving in the third eye. So that is the importance of third eye. And it is the wisdom. And that third eye is connection to the cosmic world. This is where you connect with the whole cosmos, with the whole universe. This is where you connect. Through the third eye, you connect with the whole world. Okay? So, today we'll do some meditations on the third eye. There are different ways. You can use the sound. You can use the sound like Om sound. You can use the Om sound vibrating here and then it will activate your third eye. It will give you some vibration sensation. Then another way is you can use lights. You can see bright sparkling lights, shining stars, shining moon. We'll try to use these things through watching here. Then you can use breath. You can feel that you're breathing through this third eye. You can feel your inhaled breath going there. So that is another way to activate your third eye. Okay? These are various ways of activating the third eye. So we'll try these ways. And you can also close your eyes and focus at a fixed point in between the eyebrows. Then you will activate your third eye. So we'll do these different meditations and we'll in between talk more about this. So first of all, let's try to breathe here, but we'll sit straight and we'll first go in the relaxation position. We relax the body and the mind and then we'll try to focus. So keep your back straight. Relaxed, back straight but relaxed. Don't strain yourself. Shoulders relaxed and close your eyes. Keep the eyes closed. Relax your forehead, relax your shoulders. Relax your facial muscles.